Have you ever thought about what makes a human corpse smell different than, say, a dead bird or pig? Yeah, probably not. But it's a question being answered by forensic scientists who are searching for ways to track down missing bodies. When disaster strikes, think earthquakes, mudslides, forest fires, terrorist attacks, the first order of business is, of course, to find and save survivors. But often there are fatalities. It's essential to find these missing bodies to bring closure to family members, to allow for a proper funeral, and sometimes to crack unsolved murders. But how to find these missing corpses? Well, with properly trained cadaver dogs. These canines can detect human corpses under rubble, mud, and even water by sniffing out volatile compounds unique to decomposing human bodies. Meet Inca. This is her chasing the scent of underwater human remains. And here she is swimming in a figure eight pattern to communicate that the scent is strongest right beneath her. When she was just an 18-month-old pup, Inca and her trainer joined a California disaster response team to track down people who had died in their homes as forest fires ravaged the state. Not all cadaver dogs are as good as Inca. She was trained using actual decomposing human remains. In some countries, though, it's illegal to possess human remains. In these countries, trainers turn to decomposing animals such as pigs to train cadaver dogs, which means the dogs are excellent at finding dead pigs, but not necessarily as adept with human corpses. If scientists could figure out the chemical cocktail that makes the scent of human corpses, trainers wouldn't need to use proxies or even real human parts. They could just use the synthetic scent instead. Not only would it be easier to properly train cadaver dogs, but researchers could build electronic noses that might also be deployed in disaster areas, say on a drone. But finding the precise chemicals that are unique to human decomposition turns out to be tougher than you would think. If you've watched an orange rot in a fruit bowl, you know that decomposition is a complicated and dynamic process. Decomposition in humans kicks off when a person's own enzymes and microbiome start breaking down the body. Then inhabitants of the nearby environment, such as bacteria, insects, animals, you name it, join the macabre feast. Among the hundreds of different chemicals floating off a human corpse over time, some of the most commonly measured molecules include two aromatic hydrocarbons, toluene and p-xylene, as well as dimethyl disulfide, which has a disagreeable garlicky odor. Curiously, putrescine and cadaverine, the most famous dead body smell chemicals, aren't always measured in the air around a corpse. They may be present within the dead body as a result of bacterial metabolism, but they don't always become volatile and escape. To further complicate matters for scientists hunting the scent of death, the place where a body decomposes, the desert, underwater, inside a cement block, can modify death's aroma. Even a person's lifelong diet makes an appearance postmortem. Researchers sometimes measure fluorinated compounds percolating off human corpses, such as trichlorofluoromethane. This likely shows up because a person drank fluoridated water. Scientists are still a ways away from finding the true scent of death because accounting for all these variables contributing to odor requires enough data from different environments to achieve statistical certainty, which means a lot of cadavers. In addition to the extensive ethical and legal permissions required to work with human corpses, there's a lot of competition for the cadavers donated to science. And not a lot of people donate their bodies specifically to the study of postmortem aromas. But what about you? Would you donate your body to forensic science? Tell us in the comments. And thanks for watching. If you want more chemistry videos, make sure to hit the subscribe button.